on the previous episode.
What are you doing? This isn't how you clean it. This is not an effective cleaning, elephant cleaning mechanism.
And now, continued.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and we are back playing Zoo Tycoon. And today we are going into... We're going to make our own zoo. We're going to stop campaigning for a little bit, and we're going to make our own zoo. The plan is to basically alternate between making our zoo and a campaign, so there'll be, say, two videos on making our campaign, and then there'll be two videos on making our zoo, I should say, and then two videos on, and then a video on campaign, or something like that. So we're going to move forward with both. Now, there are two options here, there's freeform mode and challenge mode, and the only difference, as far as I'm aware, between the two, is that freeform mode gives you unlimited money. Challenge mode doesn't. Now, I actually don't like the idea of unlimited money. I think it kind of ruins the point a little bit, so we are going to go for challenge mode. And as you can see in freeform mode's little text, some special animals can only be unlocked by reaching zoo fame levels in challenge mode, so we don't want to restrict ourselves anyway. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to start our own blimmin' zoo. Now, we need to pick somewhere lovely to make it. I'm thinking Scandinavia. Northern Europe, Scandinavia Zoo. It's very nice. It's nice and bright. Nice mountains and stuff. Yeah, let's go for Northern Europe. I gotta go a bit European, don't I, really? Okie dokie, here we go. First time we've ever made our own zoo. This is very exciting. I'm actually slightly nervous at this point in time. Guests are complaining about the lack of variety in animals. That's shocking, isn't it? Right. Let's get started. What can we make? Can we make anything? Now, I don't know about you guys, in my head, I know what a zoo looks like. I know that sounds like a weird sentence. We're going to start with a small tropical. Now, all the zoos I go to, and there's one main one in this area, which is called Chester Zoo. Chester Zoo, the first thing you see is elephants. So that is what we're going to kick off with here. And we're going to sort of space it so that that bit there, I want this quite close up. I don't really want to space it out too much. Boop. So the first thing you see is elephants, and I think I spaced it out well enough that kind of makes sense. So, let's go ahead and set it up for our lovely jubbly elephants. How weird is this, starting from the very start? Fame level 1. It's mad. Absolutely mad. It's awesome. I'm really quite excited. I'm going to do something as well. Basically, as the game develops, blah, 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 and we get new animals, I'm going to let you guys name them all. So that'll be fun for you guys. We'll all have a good time. Okay. So we're kicking off with elephants, and let's go ahead and adopt new animal, and elephants, and Indian elephant, and we can't really afford to be spending money on babies at this point in time. We are going to make sure we always get a male and a female though, although that is going to, that's going to financially cripple me to say the least. Let's just get Bobby at this point. Guess I'm happy with the variety of animals in my zoo. One animal is all they needed. The thing is, I need things like food and drink and entertainment and all this kind of jazz. What's the lowest? Animal variety is still the lowest problem at this moment. I suppose you walk in the zoo, and that's all you see. This is quite nice though, isn't it? Nice little close-ups. Hello, Bobby. Let's hope there's a cheap female in the elephants now that we've added him. Because once you buy one, they are replaced. Willow is... Ah, go on. Willow's definitely female, right? Yeah. Oh, they need three. Bloody hell, even this social group's not going to be enough. One more, the cheapest one, please, is Oscar. There we go. All my money's gone, but the elephants are going to be happy, which is what matters, really. Now, I want you all to bear in mind, this is going to be a bit slower paced than the campaign missions have been, just because, you know, I have to wait for money to build up, and we have to actually try and keep the zoo and its occupants properly happy. But this is, I'm quite excited. Aww. Okay. Social needs met, money going up, sort of zoo guest happiness going up as well. Hello! How are you? There's a big box behind you, sir. Look, big box. Now, in this mode as well, we are going to do things like breeding. We're going to make breeding centres, and we're going to try to breed different types of elephants. This mode, this is going to last for ages. We're going to breed all the different animal types. We're going to do everything, basically. It's going to be awesome sauce. Imagine sauce. That is more awesome than normal sauce. And how good is that photo? Yeah, cool beans. Now, I think I want my default sort of amenities kind of like at the bottom end of the zoo. Although, again, people aren't really... I'm going to wait until people complain about it, but I kind of like having like a nice little group of, say, entertainment here, some food and drink things here. Or maybe put them all at one side and we'll have the janitor office and the breeder stuff. Ooh! Hooray! Cool beans. an achievement. Huzzah! Cool, cool, cool. Cool, cool, cool. Right. Shall we get? Let's get a tropical rock as well. We're gonna have two mini exhibits flanking the elephants. That'd be cool. It's a tropical rock for now, and then we'll have another over here when we actually have an animal to put in it. And this one is gonna be a monitor lizard. Actually, we can go ahead and we're gonna build another one. But we're going to build one in a minute, and we're gonna have another tropical rock here, and we're gonna put lemurs in there. Over time, we are going to replace animals. Like, instead of having three elephants of one type, what we'll do instead is, like, just have one big tropical exhibit and put all the different elephants in there that are tropical, and maybe some other animals that go with the elephants in terms of being happy-chappies together kind of thing, you know what I mean? Oh, I'm so poor. I'm so very, very poor. So I can't really do anything right now. For the first time or so, we are going to do... Like, we're going to research print. We're going to do things like advertising, and if we go into this research menu, we're going to do this kind of thing as well when we can. I mean, over time, this all makes sense. It saves you money and all that kind of jazz. Boop. Hello. So, yeah, this is nice, isn't it? It's nice. It's lovely. I'm just chilling in the park. My guy's looking good. Chill. It's got a nice little goatee, mustache-type thing. I'm gonna nab this lovely jubbly thingy majiggy. We're gonna go on a ride right around our humongous zoo. Look at this. Absolute effort. Beep beep. There we go. Nice little roar there. Oh yeah! Hey, this thing handles pretty well. I'm quite impressed. It's like a blooming rally car. That'll do. I wonder when it disappears. Okay. Now we're just waiting for money, I suppose. What's printing? What's advertising like? How much is it? Okay. Lasts a long time, brings guests in slowly. Let's just stick that in. I guess that, you know, it'll increase my guest numbers, which increases my money at the end of the day. And let's go ahead and get ourselves our first monitor lizard called... Well, it has to be one of these two, because of money. I think Daisy's nice. And then we'll get another in a mo. Until then, let us go visit Daisy. Hello, Daisy. Hello. Hi, Daisy. You're very exciting. You're not doing much, but I'm sure you will. Where are you going, Daisy? Where are you going? That's nice. I consider myself quite a photographer, you know. Let's go meet our guests. We're all very excited. The elephants are nice and happy. Elephants always come at the start of the zoo. This is the rule. In the one zoo in my local area. There's two zoos in my local area. One of them we don't go to because it's kind of disgusting. And one that we do go to because it's really nice. Chester Zoo. I'm sure some people watching this may have been. Chester Zoo's a lovely, lovely zoo. And you go in. It's not like this. It's not tropical. It's like a sort of a more savanna grasslands type thing. Hello. Savannah grasslands type thing, but there's like this big bridge over the elephant exhibit, and there's a couple of babbies in there. It's really nice. Until then, let's go have a look. I think we get Macaw. Oh, hello. What are you doing, eh? I'm not keeping that. Where are you going? Ah. I think we've got a lemur keep. Welcome. Akul. Willkommen. Bienvenido. Boas vindas. Sorry. Welcome. No. Let's meet our... Hello. Sorry. I can't see her face. Maybe she doesn't have one. Oh, she definitely has a face. It's good to know. Sirs. Madam. Sir. The zoo is that way. I know there's butterflies here, and it's lovely. But the zoo is over there. It's quite a nice photo, that, with the elephants in the background. Aww. Try again. Yeah, there we go. That's better. Sir, no. You're going the wrong way. Oh well. It's their loss. You guys, again, the zoo. The zoo is over this way. Follow me. I shall guide you. That's right. You all pay for my zoo entrance. Oh, it's the cover. That right now is the thumbnail image for Zoo Tycoon. I wonder if any of these people actually enter. Do people actually enter your zoo? That's what I'm curious about. There's sort of mentally deficient children over there, which is nice. Child, stop that. It looks like people don't actually enter your zoo. This area just kind of stays populated, and I guess people just kind of appear. I should put down exhibits and stuff. I'm so poor. I'm so very, very poor. Yeah, entertainment, restroom, decoration, food and drink, all that kind of stuff starting to nip down a bit now. So we are going to have to look into that. Let's change the paths. These aren't very nice. What do we like? Do we like city paths? No, don't like that. What do we like? I like that. Might be a no, it's too dark, I think. That's my problem with it. What about dirt paths? No. This is tough stuff I've got to do here. Desert paths, that might look okay. Let's get a nice close-up view. That was quite nice. I think we'll stick with that one for now. And let's edit the walls, apparently. Tall? Ah! I like that. I like tall walls. Or do I like no walls? Maybe I like no walls, like really teeny tiny ones. No, I prefer that. It's nice and it's really open and spacious and stuff. That's cool. Okay. I'm just killing time until I can afford a blimmin' Nile Wizard. I know. I'm sorry, Daisy. I really am. The benches. This is important. Desert benches. They're clearly the nicest. Hooray! Apparently I get fame stuff for changing the benches. Trash cans. What do we like? I like the beach ones, actually. I think we're going to go for the beach ones for them. And finally, the trees. What do we like? Remove trees. Oh, that's weird. How weird is that? Ugh. Don't like that. Don't like that one, Dickens. I think beech trees, maybe? Do I like that? Yeah, I like that. That's quite cool. Okay, we're going to go buy a friend for our lovely jubbly Daisy. Assuming we can pretty much afford one. We're going to get Chell, for obvious reasons. I don't think... These animals can't breed anyway, so that doesn't really matter. Okay, now if you just saw that notification there, we actually got a challenge. Now, as you're doing this, you get a challenge across time, so that one we need a hose interaction, which I'm probably going to struggle to do. But you get little presents for doing them. An animal magazine wants a photograph of Nile Monitor Lizard. Take a good photo for them to use in their magazine. It's really cool, that, because it's just a way to add little extra challenges throughout the game. Instead of just building the zoo over time, I get to do little things and get a little bit more money, importantly, because I'm a little bit poor right now, in case you haven't noticed. Splendid photo. Hooray! Did I pass? I passed! And I got 1500 quid, and suddenly life's a lot easier, you know? It's cool. It's cool beans. In terms of the interaction, can we hose down elephants? I'd have to... Let's have a look. Yeah, I know. We'd have to get rid of this for a second, which I can't right now because he's spinning it right round, baby right round, like a wrecker baby right round. Which is rather irritating. Although the kids are loving it. Come on, you. So, anyways, we've got 3 elephants to name, so please leave your elephant names. And we've got 2 Nile Monitor Lizards to name as well, so please leave your suggestions and we will name them all in the next episode. I think we can name the exhibit as well. Actually, let's just, before I go check that, let's go ahead and sort this out. Build. Nope. Interactions. Hose. Yeah. Cool beans. I mean, that costs a lot of money, but we'll get 2,500 for doing it. I'm going to flog it after this anyways. But until then, let us hose an elephant. Come here, you. It doesn't get wet unless he's close enough. It's a common problem with my life, I tell you. There we go. There we go, boy. You're having fun. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Clean you up. Now, some animals I'm not going to rename. Animals that come with default amazing names, like Chell, we're probably not going to rename Chell. Okay, I'm knocking the achievements out. I don't know what's going on. What are you doing? You crazy elephant! That's new. Ah, awesome. Alright, I've never done that before. That's really cool. Let's go ahead and interactions. Edit interaction. Replace. No. Sell. Yes. Which ones? Build! Build! Okay. Build! Exhibit items, enrichments, and we want an activity center. Like so. Splendid! Splendiferous. Now, I've got a little bit of cash. We're going to go ahead and buy these things that we need. So we need entertainment. So we're going to kick things off with a lion mascot. Oh, I kind of want this near the start. And over here, we're going to do a double sort of concession bit with food and drinks. So we're going to have a soft drink stand sort of lying across there. Actually, I think that'll do for now. That's fine. Let's go ahead and get our second tropical rock, which we want to kind of look identical to that one. It's close enough. And this is going to be full of lemurs. One called Biscuit, because that's amazing. And I'm not going to quite meet the social recommendation yet, but one called Hattie. And yeah, can we rename exhibits? That's what I'm curious. Yeah, we can rename exhibits. So that's an idea as well, if you want to rename something so it's not called Tropical Small One. If you have a particularly witty elephant-based name, feel free to chuck that out there. Do what we can. What's up with our kits? Right, restrooms is quite high on the recommendations for fairly obvious reasons. Facilities, restrooms. So I'm going to put that, I think, next to the food and drink center kind of makes sense, doesn't it? Okay, cool bends. I am slightly annoyed that there's such a zoo limit on, but whatever, we'll deal with that. What else do I need? Decoration. What can we do in terms of decoration? Quite like the look of the animal totem statue. We're going to put that behind that. See what? I love symmetry, okay? I am a sucker for symmetry. I just am. Everything has to be symmetrical or it really bugs me. So that's nice and symmetrical for now. All we're doing right now is we're saving up a little bit more money to hope that we can get a third lemur so they're not a little, you know, they're a little socially unhappy, which isn't that nice. It looks good so far. It kind of looks like a spaceship. Or like the android droid if he's doing a little bit of a rave. Nyam. How's our elephants doing? Actually, what are elephants called? Do any of them have already awesome names? We have Bobby, Oscar, and Willow. All three of those can change if necessary. You know, if you guys want to name my elephants, you can name my elephant. I'll do that for you guys. I will do that for you. I think I'm happy with the trees. It feels very tropical. I mean, the background doesn't. It's big Scandinavian mountains and stuff. Actually, yeah, we're going to change the trees. Global customization. Twizzers. And we're going to change it to Alpine, I think. Yeah, that's a bit more fitting, isn't it, really? Economy breakdown. Let's have a look. We're going to have to worry about this kind of thing now. So that's cash flow, income per minute, animals, costs. So you get money from your animals due to donations. Grants, admissions, concessions, food and drink, and entertainment's making me a fortune. I really should have built them sooner. And apparently I charge for the restrooms, although they are costing. Animal variety is too little. Everything else is okay. Profitability's going up. Nice, nice, nice. Okay, so we're going to focus on getting another animal in just to kind of help that along. Anything exciting in this? It's a lot of money, that. I mean, we are going to worry about all this kind of stuff. But it's a lot of money for now. That was only, you know, they're all 1,000. And while I'm this poor, I'm not sure it's really necessary. Although that's a good idea. Maybe we'll go for that one first. Anyways, let's get ourselves our third lemur. So obviously, with this mode, there's two. It's kind of like three schools of thought. Oh, it's got cinnamon. On one hand, oh no. On one hand, it's kind of like we're going to have to wait a lot longer to see new animals. It's not going to be every episode like it has been in the past. Because, you know, we have to get up to the requisite fame levels. On the other hand, we're definitely going to see animals that we've never seen before. And we're going to see loads of animals we've never seen before down the line. You know, we've never been past fame level 20. And some animals you don't get till fame level 35. So it's going to give us a lot more options. It just gives me a lot more control. We get to do things like research that we've never really done in the past. But we do have to maintain a nice and profitable zoo, which is important. And we're also going to do breeding programs as well. I'll upgrade that. Probably shouldn't have done that, because I'm going to have to flog this at some point and replace it with a large one. Whatever, that's future best and slots problem. So, view animals... No, not what I want to do. Not what I wanted to do. I know it's full, but I just let me look at the animals. That's all I want to do. God damn it. Okay, Tropical Rock 1 is very... Now, blimmin' lizards. Pooping everywhere. Come on, you guys. Have some class. Have some class. Let's go visit the lemurs, shall we? It's a really nice looking zoo, though, isn't it? It feels... I don't know. I like it. This is cool. This is cool. New challenge. Concession shortage. Okay. Right. Soft drink standards run out of stock. Pick up new stock and a buggy from the zoo entrance. Okay, let's go. We need a buggy. Beep. I love this. I've never done this before, but I've read in the reviews people mention this. You get little challenges. Let's go, go, go. Beep. Start race. Okay. Go, go, go. We have 16 seconds. Beep. Go, go, go. Oh god. Ah, drive. 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 5 seconds. Go. Go. Hooray. That's awesome. And my food and drink shortage is still pretty damn high, oddly. Interesting. Okay. Wait, what's priority? Let me check. Ooh, decoration and animal variety. And animal variety is far more fun than decoration. So that's what we're going to focus on. And we're going to kick things off straight away with a Savannah medium, I think. I know that costs a lot of money, but Savannah medium at least will have use later on. Small exhibits, they're kind of going to lose their purpose. Although I quite like having small exhibits as well. Oh no. I mean, how many animals can I have? I can have 3 different types of elephant in there. Or we could have... An elephant, and I don't know what else would go with elephants. A hippo! We can only have one type of hippo, so we could have 2 different types of elephants in there. Or, this... Ah! I tell you what this is. I'm patting the chair that my mic's resting on, like I'm patting you on the shoulder to tell you really important information. What we could do is, when one of these is released into the wild, or until I've got another exhibit that they'll be happy with, what we can do is use this as the elephant breeding paddock. Kind of thing. What we'll do is we'll have a series of small ones like this, so a small tropical, small savanna. That'll only take 3 animals, and you put 2 animals in there. Now, I can't do that because it won't satisfy social needs. I need to breed them somehow. But the problem is, I don't think I can breed them in an exhibit that's only got a space of 3 while satisfying the social need, because they need room for the babby, but they need to want to make the babby in the first place, you know? It's a complicated life being a zookeeper, I tell you. Complicated life. Let's go over here for some reason. What are we doing? Into the buggy! Don't need to do that because I'm about to come to Savannah. So this is going to go down here behind the elephants. Exhibit. Savannah. Middle. Hooray! We've unlocked a janitor's office, a West African lion, a Siberian tiger, a hippopotamus, a carved crocodile, lots of exciting things, basically. I think this is kind of the thingy we're going to go for, decoration, because it doesn't really take up space as much as the others do. Okay, who would we want in our Savannah exhibit? I'm thinking... Not elephants. Giraffes? What about hippos? Hippos are okay. Rhinos. I'm thinking rhinos and giraffes. We're going to go for a nice rhino-giraffe mixture in there. That'd be quite cool. Say 2 rhinos, 2 giraffes, and then they can breed as well. That's what I need to be doing. 2 rhinos, 2 giraffes, or whatever meets the social need. And then there's enough room for breeding to occur. Okay, where is the poop smell? Tropical Rock 2. We haven't actually visited our lemur yet, have we? Let's meet our lemur. They're all the blimmin' same. They're all Buddha. They're kind of adorable, though. Oh, what are you doing? Hello? I know. He's a freak, isn't he? Okay. Well, then, ladies and gentlemen, this has been Best in Slot, and we've been playing Zoo Tycoon, and we really need food and drink and decorations. So we're going to go ahead and very quickly make a burger barn. over here, next to the food and drink bit. Nice little sort of concession-y type area over there, I think. That should satisfy that pretty steadily, yepers. And in terms of research, let's just get a little bit of decorations going we want. Scenery, and let's go for Alpine. Alpine Rock Small A, begin research. Okay, so next episode we're going to come back to this mode for a while. We're going to put giraffes and rhinos in that top exhibit, and we're going to look at building things like a janitor's office, a breeding centre, and some other equally super duper exciting things. Until then, thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Remember to leave your comments if you want to name our lovely jubbly animals, and I shall see you lovely people in the next episode. Cheers, much love, bye bye.